Today we're talking about an all pink, very bubblegummy look of Shraddha Kapoor that she wore for a recent film promotion. She was seen wearing a pink top. It was kind of like a fuchsia pink and it had a really statement poofy sleeve. She paired it with a pair of pink boots and she wore a really fresh face of makeup and wore her hair in a half up, half down do. Now, I think the pink looked really good and complemented her skin tone really well. The shoes, however, looked a bit too striking. I wish she would have gone with a pair of chunky dad sneakers or animal printed heels, maybe a leopard print or a cheetah print would have looked great and made for such a statement with a pink outfit like that one. And wearing all pink can be rather tricky, so it's very difficult as an adult to wear all pink and not look like a 5-year-old who's matched her outfit. But I'm going to show you just how to do it. So the first option, if you want to go for a head-to-toe pink, is to go for a deeper hue of pink. So don't go for a neon pink or a fuchsia pink. Pick a pink maxi dress like this one. It has a beautiful ruffle detail around the neckline and also has a cold shoulder. You can just slip into a maxi like this and you'd be sorted. Pair it with a pair of tan flats or brown wedges. This, I think, is a perfect dress to pack for a vacation. It's also very lightweight and very breezy and feminine. Boho accessories with this, maybe stacked up bracelet and a nice big arm candy would look great. The other way to do pink is to wear it in a shorter hemline or in an off the shoulder like this dress over here, because what it does is that your skin tone will automatically create a contrast with the bright pink color, so you don't have to worry about pairing it right. Another really easy way to do it is to just slip into a pink skater dress like this one. It's really pretty casual. The way I'd suggest you to style it is to maybe layer it with an oversized denim jacket. Wear a pair of really chunky dad sneakers and maybe a fanny pack around the waist. What's great about a skater dress is that it gives you some fun to have with the waistline because it's an empire waistline. So you could maybe pair a skinny belt with this in a contrasting color or pair a fanny pack around it and give it a very 90s look to style your pink dress. Last but not the least, if none of these shades work for you, then millennial pink has been the color of the season. So you could go for a really light pink like this one. So a top like this is perfect for your 9-to-5 looks. It's a more subtle pink if none of these pinks work for you. What you could do is pair it with your navy pencil skirt or a pair of black trousers. Just tuck it in and it would create a nice contrast. And you could incorporate pink in your everyday wear and maybe you could wear it on Wednesdays. So taking inspiration from Shraddha's all pink look, this is some ways in which you can incorporate the color into your outfit and style it right. That's all from today. I'll see you guys next time. Today we're breaking down a look of Shraddha Kapoor, who I think has aced colour blocking. I mean, recently I've seen her wear so many unusual colours together that we would have never thought to put together, but totally work. In her recent look, she was seen wearing a pair of bright yellow paperback waist shorts that she paired with a salmon pink colour cold shoulder top, and she rounded the look with a pair of white wedges. Altogether, I think the colours really work well together and the entire look worked superbly well. So, taking inspiration from the colour combination that Shraddha has just gifted to us, I have a couple of pieces and outfits to show you guys for several occasions. Starting off with a work look. So, of course, for work, you can't be wearing shorts the way Shraddha was wearing. But what you can wear is a pair of yellow or mustard trousers. These ones have a paperback waist and a tie around the waist as well. And what you could wear this with is your classic pink crisp shirt that you wear under your pantsuits, blazers, or with a pair of black trousers. Try it with a yellow trouser instead. It'll make for a very, very cute combination. For footwear, I'd suggest to go with a pair of brown leather mules or brown moccasins or even brown Oxfords would work. Now moving on to a more casual, weekend appropriate look. We have over here these mustard yellow palazzo pants. Extremely simple, breathable, super beachy and breezy. So since this is really casual and breezy and comfortable, what you could do is pair it with something a little bit more formal up top. So over here there is this nice silk snakeskin print, very boxy and comfortable top, but at the same time it has this beautiful sheen on it. It has a very formal and nice print on it, and I think it will complement this mustard yellow extremely well. I'd suggest to button it all the way up so it looks really preppy chic, and you can pair it with a pair of brown Oxfords or moccasins or brown mules again. A pair of brown wedges would work well too. Last but not the least is a look with shorts the way Shraddha was wearing. So over here we have these yellowish green neon color shorts that look very, very cute. And what you could pair this with is something from the pastel family. So over here you're including two trends, you're including pastel as well as neon. This camisole over here is a nice lavender color, and while we're all in the sea of neons and all about bright colors this season, we're slowly ignoring lavender colors and how rich and classy they look. So you could have the best of both worlds with an outfit like this one. A pair of white wedges, the way Shraddha was wearing, your hair up in a ponytail, and a very, very fresh and dewy face of makeup would look absolutely fantastic with an outfit like this one. So that's all from this episode of We Down Style Under 3. I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Today we're talking about a look of Shraddha Kapoor, where she was recently seen for the promotions of her upcoming film Saho. She wore a really casual and very breezy look. She was seen wearing a white button-down midi skirt that had a slit from below the knee. It also had a paper bag waist, and it was like this ruffle effect that they'd created around the waist. She paired the look with a floral printed blouse. It was green in color and it had multiple colors of floral prints on it. So that added a pop of color along with the white skirt. The blouse also had a wrap style detail along with really poofy sleeves. So the top was quite the statement, while the skirt was really structured, fitted and super chic. She kept the accessories minimal. She wore her hair in a half up, half down do, a really fresh face of makeup, and PVC heels completed her look. So we have a few pieces here to help you recreate this look of Shraddha Kapoor. Starting with the skirt, I have something very similar. This lacks the drama via the paper bag effect, but this nice beige skirt has the drama through the pockets over here. And I think I just love it when dresses and skirts have pockets. It's so convenient because you can just slide your phone inside. So as you can see, this is a button-down skirt. You can make it a mini skirt also by opening a button or two. But I think it looks really chic this way. This again is a midi skirt. The length and fit of this is such that I would recommend you guys to style it with a pair of heels, because it will only elongate the lower half of your body, and a midi skirt always looks best with a pair of heels. Now to pair it up top, Shraddha was wearing a really dramatic top that had poofy sleeves, so you could pick something similar. Over here we have this top that again has a V-neck detail. It has a bit of ruching around the neckline and it has poofy sleeves as well. This one is a peplum top, so I'd recommend leaving it outside over the skirt instead of tucking it in. So this is one combination that you could try. The other one I would recommend is to go with a really trending print nowadays, and no, it's not animal print, it's scarf print. This scarf printed shirt has a dual tone to it. It has a blue and a cream, and a scarf print is a massive trend in dresses and shirts and even pants for that matter of fact. And because it's such a statement and it's a different and quirky sort of a print, pairing it with a structured skirt like this one or something similar to what Shraddha was wearing would help you achieve her look, which is perfect for a brunch or even a dinner out with friends and family. That's all from today. I'll see you guys next time.
For more fashion tips, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon.